And I'm trying to get control here in the Toronto Film Festival of the picture control, and the buzz is out of control on young Sam Riley. Hey, Sam.
Hi.
Welcome to the Stephen Holt Show.
Lovely to meet you.
Hey, my God. You're here. You are in Toronto, and you're in Variety with this write-up on the guy to watch and all this stuff. Yeah.
I didn't know about that.
Oh, you didn't know about that?
No.
Well, Variety had, you didn't tell them there, that Variety had this whole, you know, bunch of people, like five, six, it was a small group, and there was your picture there and over there, and...
Really?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
I'll tell my mom.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Now you're on the Stephen Holt Show, and so your movie Control. I mean, you're practically the whole movie. You have to carry this very serious film, and I did not know anything. I have no musical background. I'm a theater critic and a film critic. I did not know anything about this band. I thought it was just a fiction film, and then of course at the end you find out it's a true story.
Yeah.
Oh my God! Did you know about Joy Division before you started?
I didn't know.
I've never heard of them.
I knew of them. I knew their song "Love Will Tear Us Apart," which is probably the most well known. But I didn't know all that much about them, if I'm honest. I knew two or three songs, and I knew what had happened to him.
How did you get through the audition process of this? I mean, how did you know you've gone from unknown to actual superstar now?
I don't know whether that's strictly
true.
Variety
said so. So I think I'm pretty.
Well, they're always right. Aren't they?
Yeah, they're always right.
Always.
That's all we've got left is Variety. So what? So what, how did that happen for you?
Pretty crazy coincidence, really. I was working in a warehouse in Leeds, folding shirts. I'd had a failed attempt at being a rock star, like most English young men, and then I rang an agent that I knew from 4 years previously and said, "Is there anything going on?" I asked if they cast James Bond, and she said they had, which was a big disappointment. But then she said they're making this Ian Curtis movie. I knew he was the singer from Joy Division from the other movie they did about him, 24 Hour Party People.
Ah, uh-huh.
But he was only a small part of that movie. And then I went along, I did three auditions. I met Anton at the third one and did the dance for him. And
are you doing your own singing in the movie?
Yeah.
That's incredible.
Yeah, I loved
it. Incredible.
Thank you.
So you're coming from a musical comedy background or a musical? Well, you had your own band, you said?
Yeah, yeah. I was a professional musician for 3.5 years. We were signed to Polydor, called 10,000 Things, but the reason none of us have heard of it is the reason I'm sat here now, I think.
But I think it's much better. I think you found your level. You know, we all sort of go through transitions in life,
yeah,
and we end up where we don't think we're going to be, and here you are. The hot flavor buzz at the Toronto World Film Festival. This is the biggest film festival in the world now. It's bigger than Cannes, you know.
Is it?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, well, I'm honored then. Fantastic.
Because Cannes has all these crazy movies nobody wants to see in the United States. And this has the movies that the U.S. wants to see, basically.
Yeah.
Which are the American films, you know. Because we're so narrow-minded, unfortunately. But your beautiful movie in black and white...
Mm.
You know, what an incredible look, and Samantha Morton, one of the great screen actresses.
Yeah,
going
she's
tonight.
Incredible. Yeah, fantastic.
Yeah, she could get an Oscar nomination for that, supporting for best.
She should do. Yeah, definitely.
You're playing your wife. What was her name? Debbie.
Debbie Curtis.
See, I remembered her name.
Very
Debbie.
Good.
It penetrated the whole thing about how you kept wanting to return to her and then
choose
leave
between
her.
This the lovely Alexandra.
Right, who I just interviewed, and
yeah,
she told me she was Hitler's secretary. I didn't recognize her from Downfall.
Mm.
And so what was the hardest thing about this for you?
I don't
know.
The
auditions?
The audition was embarrassing, dancing around a room like that, but the hardest thing was knowing that how many crazy Joy Division fans there are out there. That
oh.
Yeah, they're a secret bunch, but they are there. And... And trying to get this crazy dance down in front of my mirror at home, and I don't know. I was nervous about working with Samantha, obviously, because I knew how incredible she was, and also how intense apparently she can be on these movie sets. But she was fantastic with me and Anton, because both of us, this is both of our first movies. That's the director and myself.
Wow.
So she showed us the ropes to begin with, and then. She's fantastic.
And he's an epileptic, too.
Yeah.
P.S.
P.S.
And a manic depressive, it seemed.
Yeah.
Undiagnosed, probably. I mean, they didn't know in those days.
No, but the medication from the epilepsy also had sort of psychological side effects on you, which brought around black moods and...
Oh.
So, I mean, he was already probably leaning in that direction anyway, but that didn't help.
Wow. Yeah. Because, I mean, and he, and of course, everyone knows that he had a very tragic... And is that all true, that whole recreation of...
Yeah, no, apparently so.
I didn't want to go into it. You have to see the movie Control, which is what we're talking about. I didn't want to get bogged down to into a Sylvia Plath conversation.
Too much. Get the tissues out.
I know. What are you... What's happened for you since you finished Control?
It's been very quiet, really, the last year. Because nobody has a clue who I am still. And so I found it very hard to get any work. But since Cannes, then a few more people have been slightly interested.
Take a look at this week's Variety. It'll make you very happy very depressed. I don't know.
I don't know. I'm always on the verge, yeah.
Yeah, because they said lots of beautiful things about you.
All right.
Yeah, that you're fantastic. This rising star, and we all should pay total attention to whatever it is you're doing. And,
that's very nice of them.
Yeah.
Yeah,
yeah, and what a wonderful performance. And you're on the poster. It's always
smoking,
helps.
Yeah.
Yeah, smoking. Do you smoke in real life? Or?
Yeah, I do, yeah.
You do, yeah. I did.
Which helps, yeah.
Which helps, right, back in the day. Anton and I both sort of rounded London in the late 70s, but we didn't know each other then. But he was a photographer just starting out, he was a Dutch photographer, and I was doing fringe theater, as a matter of fact.
Oh, yeah, as an actor.
As an actor, too, I work with Gay Sweatshop, as a matter of fact. But I'm also a playwright and director. I worked at the Soho Poly and all those places.
You know,
the
cool.
Uncle House and everything. So, you know, never know. Maybe if nobody's got a part for you, I'm sure I can find one.
If you've got one of your old plays handy.
Right.
Yeah.
Oh, I have. I think I've got my bags over there, so I'll get them.
I don't mind working in a Gay Sweatshop.
Yeah. Oh, well, that's what it feels like today in this.
It is a little
so
bit, isn't
hot.
It?
The heat is being generated by Control and by Sam Riley's very, very hot career. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Lovely to meet you.
Good sport and a very, very talented actor and singer.
Thank you. Cheers.
Cheers. Have a fabulous.